years. Now we try to learn the preparation of the one-fina azo tuna. It comes under the azo dye category. Azo dye. Dye means a colored stuff or a color. Here azo dyes contain diazo group in them. Diazo group. Azote means nitrogen gas. Look here. Nitrogen gas is called as azote. Nitrogen gas is called as azote. So all azote dyes contain diazo group in them. Diazo group. That means they contain this group. Okay, in between two nitrogen atoms, one double bond is there in them. So all such compounds are known as the azote dyes. Okay. So many azote dyes are there, but here in our lab now we have to prepare one phenyl azo 2 naphtho. Here preparation of this compound involves two steps. Here first step is the diazotization. Diazotization means the reaction in which benzene diazonium salt is prepared. In diazotization we prepare diazonium salt. So sometimes name of the reactions get the name of the product which are formed in those reactions. For example, in haloform reaction, the product is the haloform. Okay, no? So in the diazotization, diazonium salts are the products. So for that purpose, here we have to react aniline. Aniline means, if you write NH2 group on the benzene, that becomes as the aniline. And the formula is C6H5NH2. C6H5NH2. This is known as aniline. So, to form the diazonic salts, we have to treat aromatic primary amine. Here, as the aromatic primary amine, we are taking the aniline. Okay? This has to be reacted with the nitrous acid. Nitrous acid. But nitrous acids are unstable. So we prepare nitrous acid in the lab whenever we require that one. Okay? So nitrous acid is prepared by mixing sodium nitrite with the HCl solution. So first of all, we have to make the NaNO to aqua solution and we have to add HCl solution. Okay? So whenever we require, we have to prepare nitrous acid by mixing sodium nitrite. Sodium nitrite with HCl solution. Okay. For this purpose, we have to maintain a very low temperature. Here, we first of all, we have to prepare the sodium nitrite aqueous solution in the one test tube, and we have to prepare HCl. We have to take the HCl solution in another test tube, and we have to cool them. Okay. We have to maintain very low temperatures, because at high temperatures, this nitrous acid is unstable. It decomposes into the nitric acid and nitric oxide. Nitric oxide, like this. Look here. Nitrous acid is very unstable. So, at high temperatures, what happens, it decomposes and gives the nitric acid and nitric oxide. Nitric acid and nitric oxide. This is nitric acid. And this is nitric oxide. And look at H2. So like that you decomposes. The balanced reaction is like this. Okay. 6 atoms here. So like that you decompose. Here NO, actually NO has no color, but whenever it reacts with oxygen, immediately it forms nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide is a reddish brown color gas. It is a reddish brown color gas. Reddish brown color gas. So, if these two solutions are not cooled sufficiently, then we get the reddish brown color fumes or gas. So, immediately you have to start adding HCl to the NaNO2 and again you have to cool that. Because if the fumes go outside, if the nitrogen goes outside, you don't get the azo dye. Okay, so for that purpose, we have to cool the sodium nitrate solution and HCl solution sufficiently. Okay, so then whenever we add the nitrous acid to the aniline, we get benzene diazonium salt like this. Benzene diazonium salt like this. This salt is known as benzene diazonium chloride. We can easily remember this one. Look here. We get the benzene diazonium chloride. This salt is known as benzene. Look at benzene. Di means to, eta means nitrogen atom, m means plus. So this salt is known as benzene diazonium chloride. Benzene diazonium chloride. So this is the product formed in the first step. I think it. Here these two are colored solutions and NaD is also a colored solution, colored liquid. So all these reactants are colors. And here you get a yellow color solid here. So benzene diazonium chloride is a yellow color solid. If you don't get the yellow color solid here, you need to go to stop and again you go to restart the experiment for the first step. Okay na? So after getting the benzene diazonium chloride, you have to proceed for the second step. You have to proceed for the second step. Second step is addition of the benzene diazonium chloride to the beta naphthol. So here second step is the actual preparation step. Preparation of azotide. So here we may prepare azotides by taking the enlil as well as by taking the phenol as well as by taking the naphthol. But here we take the 2-naphthol. Look here. This is benzene. Okay? Its formula is C6. If you write the two benzene rings side by side, if you write two benzene rings side by side, that becomes the naphthalene. This is known as the naphthalene. Naphthalene. This is benzene. And if you write the three benzene rings side by side, we call it as the anthracene. Anthracene. This is anthracene. So all these are known as the fused aromatic compounds. Here, these compounds are infused with benzene rings. Okay. So here we have to take the beta naphthol or 2-naphthol. If we put hydroxy group, we call it as the naphthol. This is the alpha position and this is the beta position. Beta and alpha. So here we take the beta naphthol or 2-naphthol. Beta naphthol or 2-naphthol. 2-naphthol. Then we have to add the benzene diazonium chloride yellow color solid here. Otherwise, we have to add the naphthol to the benzene diazonium chloride here. Here is a yellow color solid. Okay. Then what happens means here we get a orange red color solid. That orange red color substance or solid is the product that we require here. So here we get this one. So this is the compound that we want to prepare. This compound is known as the 1-phenyl-azo-2-naphthol. 1-phenyl-azo-2-naphthol. 2-naphthol. And it is having orange red color. Orange red color. It is the orange red color substance. Right. Now we go for the experimental part. So for that purpose we move to the lab. Thank you.
For the preparation of the 1-phenyl-azo-2-naphthol, we require the 5 chemicals. First one is the sodium nitrite. Second one is the hydrochloric acid. And the third one is aniline. Fourth one is the beta naphthol. And the fifth one is the sodium hydroxide. So, first of all, we have to take the sodium nitrite in the test tube. It is better to take in a large amount. Why? Because even if nitrous acid is formed, it may decompose. So it is better to take the sodium nitrate in a large amounts. So we add water to this one and we make it aqueous solution. We make it into aqueous solution. So we take salt in large amounts and we dissolve in the limited amount of water. Okay, na? So this is the sodium nitrite solution and we keep it in the ice water. Ice water like this. And then after in another test tube we take the HCl solution. We take the HCl solution. Yeah, this is the HCl solution. You take the HCl solution in another test tube like this. We keep it in the ice cold water like this. Ice cold water. Ice cold water. Then after we have to take sodium nitrite. Sorry, aniline. Aniline in another test tube like this. Actually, aniline has no color. But if it is stored for a long time, it undergoes oxidation with the aerial oxygen and it changes into the some oxidizer products. As a result, it becomes black. So, but anyhow, it also contains some amounts of aniline. That portion of aniline gives us the required test. So, there is no need to worry. In taking this oxidized aniline. So we use this one only, no problem. Aniline, we keep it aside. And then after we take the betanophthol in another test tube. Betanophthol, this is betanophthol or 2-naphthol. To this one, we add sodium hydroxide solution and we dissolve it. Sodium hydroxide solution and we dissolve it. To dissolve it, we have to cover it with a paper and we dissolve it in the any other solution. Okay. Now, we add HCl solution to the sodium nitrite. So actually we should not add the HCl completely to the NaNO2. First of all, we have to add in small amounts and we have to check whether bubbles are coming or not. If bubbles raise, then we have to stop adding HCl to the sodium nitrate and again we have to cool it. So bubbles are not coming, I think. Okay, so I think these aqua solutions are sufficiently cooled. So this is the nitrous acid. So whenever we add HCl to the sodium nitrate, we get the nitrous acid. To this, we add the aniline. Okay, this aniline. If you get the yellow color product, that yellow color product will be benzene diazonium chloride. We have to stir it thoroughly. Okay, we are getting a yellow color solid, that is benzene diazonium chloride. After this, after getting this one, we have to add the betanophthol dissolved in the NaOH solution to this one. We get orange red color precipitate. Look here. We got orange radical process, so it is nothing but azo, 1-phenyl azo betanophthol. So this is the preparation method. Okay, right, thank you.
Okay.
Right.